shine. Ow! Stop and fight us. Hey! Oh! Hit it, Len. Hit it, Len. The world is going crazy. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Tony Commander J.R. Galpohkpa Chesson Talk Show. Today is September the 23rd. Let's get into this thing. Today is another day for Liberians to live and become aware of their plight as human beings on this planet. This morning, I'm sitting where I belong, in prison. I am a correctional officer, and I am the officer that will bring the positive changes Liberia needs. Attorney Commander J.R. Galpohkpa Chesson is the right leader for Liberia today and to set the standards for our country to grow and prosper tomorrow and forever. The time of the Liberian people is now. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I've been listening to all the dysfunctional talks of the things that are going on in our country. I listened to about 4 or 5 people this morning, including Hawa Meska, including Duke Ajay, JJ, including Sam Jackson, including Ambassador Don. I listened to all of them, and they all have problems with our country and the leadership of our country and the direction in which our country is moving. And it is evident that nobody in Liberia now can save Liberian people from the plight they are on right now. The plight that is leading us to destruction, to bankruptcy. We are already bankrupt, but to destruction and forever maligning our country with criminals and law and wicked people of the world. We can't go on living like this. We've been living like this since Charles Taylor and Ben and I Ewer time, when Ben and I Ewer was a gun runner, stealing all our money, stealing everything we own for themselves. Now we come this far, and the same thing is going on. Ellen Johnson King and Dale Hopper were children. Now, Ambassador Don said something in his show that I didn't think about, but it's true. He said that under Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, Ellen Comey sat down and remained quiet, despite all of her criminal actions and all of her nepotistic actions in Liberia. He kept quiet. Why? Because he believed that his cousin Ellen was going to recommend him to the international community as her replacement. Good leadership for Liberia. And what she did, she stabbed him in the back too. All the way he was loyal to Ellen. He sat there with his cousin Ellen, hoping that she would give him the chance to take over Liberia and be the one to be introduced to the international community as her replacement. She deceived him. She deceived him. And this is why I told you, Alec Cummings is a novice. He's a little boy in Liberian politics. He got all that money, and they come to feel that they own Liberia. They can rise up and the Liberian people will follow them. But that's not the case. We can't take the same corrupt people and keep putting them in power. And it proves that Ellen Johnson, Ellen Comey is just corrupt as Ben and I, you and all of them. Because after he found out that Ellen Johnson betrayed him, he said that he's looking for good people to collaborate with. He goes to the same old criminals in Liberia, Ben and I, you, Borka, ALP, and Don Toyo, how before Brumskin died, he thought he was going to be picked by Ellen Johnson to replace her too. He went and ordered all these vehicles for his party. Now, nobody know where the vehicles are. After he died of frustration from fighting, from following Ellen and having her lie to him over and over, then she chose George, we are over all of them. He died from frustration, you see. He thought he was going to replace Ellen too. He bought all those pickups and things for a company, for a party. Now nobody know where the cars are. People took those cars and finished stealing them and redesigning them. Don said, you see your old pickup, you see that they see their old pickup, they will not know that the pickup set because the people finish changing all the design of the pickup. Using the tow coal and different things as their own personal vehicles. And Charles Bronson family is left with all this bill for his political party. But who cares? Or the party left with all the bill. But this is deceit that has been going on in Liberia from time immemorial. And this is the same deceit that we are under today. Now, it is evident that our traditional leaders don't care about the tribal people. Our traditional leaders only care about power, only care about politics. They don't care about the people. Because I listened to Don, the same ambassador Don from Nima County, talking about how ANC have destroyed themselves. How Elliott Cummings went and put his trust in Benin Ayure, and every time he won't run for a senator, won his party run for a senatorial position, Benin Ayure then would say, no, wait, you running for the president. Let us take the other position. And he gave it up and let him take. So Don wanted to know how Elliott Cummings will be president of Liberia when his party has no senatorial seats. All the senatorial seats are for the other members of the CPP. So how will he ever pass things that would benefit him and his leadership when everybody else in the party owns the senatorial and legislature seats? So right there, he is handicapped. He followed those guys and they fooled him over and over, telling him to sit down and wait for the president and say, you're coming. You know, put him in as the chairman of the party and all of that. They fool you. That's cutting the politics. That LU politics they use on you, Elliott Cummings. And all the little people in America, Duke JJ, and Yacinda, all of them, they don't know Liberian politics. I saw it from the beginning. I said, you're a failure. You're not capable to lead the Liberian people. You're not strong enough. Liberian people need a strong man right now. They need a man who will tell them to move, and you do. If they don't move, they will feel the consequences of my action. And this is the Tony Commander, J.R. Galpohkpa Chesson. Because our leaders in Liberia are useless. So going on with Don, he was talking about Elliott Cummings and how Elliott Cummings had failed. And the first thing that came to his mind was, if there were country, if there were native people, Elliott Cummings could control them. But they're not native people, they're all the same. That means they're all intelligent Congo people. So they will argue among themselves. Native people are ignorant and docile and can be controlled by anybody because they're dumb. And this is what our leaders feel about their own people. This is how our Liberian tribal people feel about their own people. Their own people are docile, ignorant, and be controlled by anybody. And this is not the way our people are supposed to be taught about. This is not the way the leaders of Liberia are supposed to think about their own people, or Liberian people who are opposed to one party supposed to think of the other people. Yeah, but this is Liberia. Our leaders have no empathy or love for Liberian people. Now, our passports have been sold forever. Our passport ain't worth nothing. Now, after Mary Brewer have tried to bring reputation back, bring the reputation of our passports back on the world scene, George Weah them have taken our passports and given it to criminals, drug dealers, and terrorists. Wesson Guy Finley is accused of giving 4,200 passports to people who are not Liberian, diplomatic passports. And now Liberia is on the CIA watch as a terrorist nation, as a nation that supports terrorism. And they got to pay for it. Our nation deserves far better than this. Even right now in Liberia, only 15 and 19 years old getting pregnant, more than anybody in our country. And our women are dying in childbirth. They say for every 1,000 childbirth, 600 to 700 women are dying because the treatment, because the care they're getting is mediocre. It's not right. Now it's getting so bad that America is going back to putting people on blacklists. They can't leave Africa to come to America. And y'all know America is the country y'all love to come to. But this thing can't go on in our country. Our country and our people can't continue to be subjected to the criminal leadership of the Liberian government. $16 billion disappear. We never know what came of that money. They're lying. He put the Nigerian man in charge of anti-corruption so he can cover up all the dirt they're doing, all the stealing they're doing. How you take a Nigerian man and put him in our anti-corruption unit? Now the Congress, the legislature, questioning everything he's doing, and George Weah refusing to move him, so he keep him there. These things are unnatural for our country. They are unreal. Look at the health workers. George Weah can't pay the people. They got no money. All they do is fight for the $24 million they got to pay the employees, and they finish. They don't care about nothing else in Liberia. Once the people pay it and they're not complaining, everything goes on as usual. But this is Liberia we're coming to. This is Liberia we're facing. Now all of them will meet the consequences for their actions. And here's my jail. I am a correctional officer. I am a Liberian who will correct the ways, the attitudes, and the behaviors of my people. Attorney Commander J.R. Galpohkpa Chesson is the man to resurrect the Liberian Republic that where it's supposed to be, greater than ever before. We're not going back into that same old system. I don't want to go under the old order. Liberia deserves good leadership. We deserve profound leadership. We deserve a new style of leadership that cares for our people, that understand the plight of our country and our people, and are willing to stand up to resurrect the decency, the honor, and the prestige of Liberia and the Liberian people. George Weah government is a useless, roguish, disgusting government. Liberian native leaders are nothing but disgusting, useless men who care nothing but corruption and stealing. The diaspora Liberians, we are the light of the Republic of Liberia. And these evil men who are useless, incompetent, and evil want to stop us from coming home. When I get ready to go home, I need 5,000 to 10,000 Liberian people rising up and going home with me. We gotta change our country. We gotta move these native people from our government and install the American Liberian government that will lead Liberia back to liberation and freedom. This native government is not the government for the people, by the people, and of the people. This is a government of grown-up boys, of wayward children, and of useless Liberians. We have to reel this government in. We have to reel Ellen Johnson Sirleaf in. This is where they belong, in jail. And I am the jailer of Liberia. I will take care of you and never be fooled. I will give you a good treatment in my prison for all of you coming to jail. Ben and I, you, Borka, all of you're listed for jail. The time of Liberian people is now. Aluta! Continue. Have a good day, my people.